Hey, what's up YouTube? Today we're going to be doing something a little different. We're going to give you guys a walk around of the stroller. We've had a couple of requests of wanting a walk around, so we're going to get to that right now. When we picked up the Sandrail or buggy, stroller, whatever you guys want to call it, it was completely different. We basically did everything except the actual frame and the arms. So I'm going to start off with the wheels. It had some smaller wheels. We ordered these bigger ones off of Home Depot. Actually, I have a fifth one because we were going to put a spare on there. And we just decided not to. So we replaced the bolts that hold the wheel on because the other ones were smaller. And we got these rings made. They are aluminum rings. We got some holes on there with some bolts to make them look like beadlocks. And moving on over to the shocks, it had some shocks off of a like a hatch from a vehicle, the really thin shocks. So we replaced them with these, make it look like the king shocks. And we had to cut these little notches right here to make them fit. Welded some new tabs down here and up here as well. Ordered all new end caps. Make the skid plate, has some tabs right here to mount it on. That's a little light bar, has a light bar up here. So it's pretty wide. We don't really take it out because it takes up all the sidewalk, so basically just sits here. Right here on the side, we have our logo with our YouTube channel on there. And it was spray painted black, so we got it all powder coated. These panels were just aluminum, you know, silver. So we wrapped it pink. And the reason we wrapped it is because if one day we decide to get rid of it, whoever owns it could just rewrap it whatever color they want. It'll be easier than stripping off the paint and all that. So up here it had a leather piece that went down to like about here. Kind of like a U-shape back here. Took that off. We welded on some tabs and we made this aluminum piece. It's also wrapped. Back here, we also did these tabs to mount the shocks. These arms weren't touched, just the end caps. And this is a piece of PVC, which we had to make because the wheel is bigger, so it came in contact with the shock. So we just cut a piece of PVC and we spray painted it black. We replaced all the hardware with grade 8 so it can stand out a little more. This is the battery that powers all of our stuff up in the dash. I'll show you guys in a bit. So we ran the power all the way to the front. And the ground is just bolted to the frame. For the floor pan, it had a piece of like mesh, metal mesh up in front, but it was too easy to put your finger in there and get cut. So we cut that out and we made this aluminum diamond plate, a floor pan for it. Just bolted down. For the steering, it had a very thin piece of metal, which would flex. So we got this 1-inch tube and we cut the old stuff out and welded this little piece in there to make it work. So when you steer up here, it'll turn the front wheels. This is the steering wheel. Kind of want to replace it with something a little nicer, but for now this will do. So now I'm gonna talk to you guys about the dash. For the dash, we replaced the steering wheel because this was missing on the old one. And we got some 3-inch speakers. This one here, one on that side. GPS, a switch panel, Bluetooth marine radio, and a voltmeter, key ignition. Let me turn that on for you. You push it in, and then you can see the volts. Everything powers up. I'm not gonna play any music, but it's decent. It's not super loud, but it's, you know, you're able to hear it. And GPS functional. And also the lights, so turn them on. This is for the rear. The bumper, the lower bumper light, and the windshield light. So for this rear light, we have this little controller came with it. We have it aiming down a little bit because it's pretty bright. So you just press, A. It has different functions. You're pressing it. I'll change the function. Press B and it'll turn off. And for the front, let me flip it around and show you guys. This is what it looks like with the lights on. They're super bright. Click them. Let's put them off. This is the little light underneath the tubular bumper. We'll also make that skid plate. That's the windshield light. Little tabs. A little tab right there. So we're thinking of taking it apart, powder coat everything white again, except the arms, but we're not sure. Also, we would like to add some more speakers and even a little subwoofer, 6.5-inch subwoofer. But as it is, it's pretty heavy, so we have to, you know, think about that. And the seat needs to be not redone, just like stapled back in place. It's a little custom-made seat. We also welded this on so that's back support, you know, make it look a little more real, because we were going to do some harness seat belts, but we never got to that. We routed the wires as neat as possible. Some right here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little walk around video. Make sure to follow us on Instagram at @yonke_oxfilms. I'll leave that in the description down below. And we'll catch you in the next one.